If afforded an opportunity, my government is committed providing the Divyangjan equal opportunities for development. Besides increasing the percentage of reservations for Divyangjan from 3% to 4% in the government jobs, my government has accelerated filling up of backlog vacancies. Over 6 lakh Divyangjan have so far benefited from 47,000 special assistance camps organized across the country since May 2014. Honorable members, the Sugamya Bharat Abhiyan is improving accessibility of the Divyangjan at public places. For the first time, speech and language disability and specific learning disability have been included in the Rights of Persons with Disabilities Act 2016. A common sign language is being developed for the entire country. The Nirama Swasth Bima Yojana provided Divyangjan effectively affected by autism, cerebral palsy, mental retardation, and those with multiple disabilities a health insurance cover of up to 1 lakh rupees. Like the strings of sitar, which produces different notes, but come together to create a beautiful melody. People professing of different faiths and religion constitute the spirit of India and contribute to the strength of the nation. The courage and sacrifice of Baba Bande Singh Bahadur, whose 300th martyrdom anniversary, spirit of selfless service of Mother Teresa, who was canonized recently, inspire us in equal measures. My government has taken several measures to ensure that the aspirations of the people from all communities are fulfilled, and a more focused approach has been taken towards inclusive development of the notified minority community, namely Muslims, Christians, Buddhists, Sikhs, Parsis, and Jains. While scholarship and fellowship schemes have encouraged their educational employment, skill development schemes like Shekho or Kamau, Ustad and Naimanjil have enabled their economic empowerment. Honorable members, just as all the drops of rainwater and streams converging in one ocean, all the policies of my government converge for the welfare of the poor, deprived, and the underprivileged. From giving house to the shelteredless, to electrifying unelectrified village, from giving free LPG connection, to supplying LED bulbs to the poor, from Jan Dhan to Jan Suraksha, from making available affordable health care to providing quality education to the poor, central to all the policies of my government is the welfare of the poor. Balanced and equitable developments of all regions vital to India's progress. Under its proactive activist policy, my government is focusing on reducing the isolation of the eastern region and northeast by improving connectivity through road, rail, telecom, power and waterways. Honorable members, my government has started Pradhan Mantri Urja Ganga with the execution of 2,500 kilometers long Jagdishpur, Haldia, Bokaro, Dhamra National Gas Pipeline Project. With an investment of around ₹12,500 crores, this project will cater to energy requirements of 5 states covering 40 districts, 2,600 villages. The project will also lead to the revival of 3 large fertilizer plants, industrialization of more than 20 cities, and the city gas network development in 7 cities. My government sees the northeastern states as the Ashtalakshmi, that they can take India to new heights. The northeast is the gateway to Southeast Asia. We are opening up road and rail route to our neighboring countries to boost the economic development of the region. To ensure unhindered support and development of northeastern states, my government is continuing with the special dispensation that the assistance pattern of the northeastern states and is providing assistance in the ratio of 90-10 for core central schemes and 80-20 to non-core central schemes of these states. Honorable members, by the end of the year, all meter gauge tracks in the northeastern states will be converted into broad gauge. The railways have undertaken a major expansion in the region at a cost of around ₹10,000 crores. Arunachal Pradesh and Meghalaya have been put on the rail map. Agartala in Tripura has been connected with broad gauge line. The Brahmaputra Kakar and Polymer Limited at Numaligarh, Refinery Limited, Works Unit are big projects that will create huge employment opportunities in the Northeast region. The government has approved the Northeast BPO promotion schemes in the Digital India program for creation of employment opportunities. The beauty and diversity of the Northeast states is a natural hub for tourism. The Ministry of Tourism has identified the thematic circuit for the Northeast region. My government has provided special financial assistance to mitigate the damages caused by the unprecedented floods in the hilly and other areas of the country. Honorable members, from highways to highways, from railways to waterways, from seaports to airports, from water pipelines to gas pipelines, from earth sciences to satellites, from rural infrastructure to smart cities, creation of vital next generation infrastructure has received special attention of my government. For modernization of railways, the highest ever capital outlay of rupees 1.21 lakh crore has been provided. My government aims to connect all rural habitations with all-weather roads. 73,000 kilometers of road has been built so far in the rural areas. More than 5,000 kilometers of roads in 44 left-wing extremist districts are being upgraded. The National Civil Aviation Policy will give a major boost to air connectivity in the small towns and cities. Under the BharatNet project, optical fiber cables now cover over 75,000 gram panchayats, up from only 59 in May 2014. India has launched 8 operational missions covering meteorological, navigation, and earth observation and communication satellites. ISRO completed the 7th satellite constellation of India regional navigational satellite services, NAVI. SRO added another feather to its cap this year by successfully launching 20 satellites in a highest ever single launch.
तो राष्ट्रपति का अभिभाषण जारी है और अगर इसके अंदर जो चीज़ें की गई, जो हाईलाइट्स कहे गए, वो आपको बताते हैं। शुरुआत में ब्लैक मनी को सराहना की उन्होंने, जिस तरह सरकार ने इसको पूरी ही मामले को हैंडल किया वो काफ़ी सराहनीय है। साथ ही साथ सब्सिडी को गिव अप करना भी उन्होंने कहा कि काफ़ी पॉजिटिव कदम रहा अर्थव्यवस्था के लिए। जनशक्ति के जरिए जो अकाउंट खोले गए उससे राष्ट्र निर्माण को लेकर एक बड़ी मदद मिली है, और उसके अलावा जनधन अकाउंट और जन सुरक्षा के जरिए सोशल स्पेंडिंग जो गवर्नमेंट ने की है वो भी काफ़ी हद तक सराहनीय कदम बताया गया। पोस्टल बैंक को लेकर उन्होंने बात की कि एक और सरकार की तरफ से माइलस्टोन है जो कि उन्होंने अचीव किया है। करीब करीब 1,50,000 पोस्ट ऑफिस जो कि पोस्टल बैंक के जरिए कामकाज कर रहे हैं। लेकिन इस बीच मार्केट जो है वो दिन के निचले स्तरों पर आ चुका है। 55 को गिरावट देखी जा रही है, 8578 का लेवल निफ्टी में देखने को मिल रहा है।